Hello everyone, Danas here with ActionVFX. In this video, we will learn about 2D motion tracking in DaVinci Resolve Fusion. I'm going to introduce you to the concept of motion tracking and how you can use it to track in stock footage like this planet. So, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so here we are in Fusion in DaVinci Resolve. Here I have our background plate in my Media 1. And this background plate is from pexels.com. You can download this on the description below. And then on Media 2 here, I have this deformed moon element from our ActionVFX Sci-fi Planets collections that you can check out on the description as well. And then this planet, I scaled it down and moved it to the top using transform. And then I merged it on top of the plate. So now before we blend in our planets better, we can see that the planet is standing still, not following the movement of the shot. So to fix that, we are going to do some motion tracking. So what we're going to do is we want to mimic the movement of the background plate of the Media 1 and then apply that movement to our planet so it sticks to the sky. So let's do that. First, I want to delete the merge node here, and then we're going to right click, add tool, and let's get tracker, and then one hold shift and put it in between the media in and media out. So on our tracker node, we can see that we have created a little something here called tracker one, as you can see on the tracker list there. So the way this works is we want to select a point in the scene and then follow the movement of that point. And from that, we want to generate a transform data from it, like position, scale, and rotation. And then we want to use that generated data and apply it to our element that we want to stick into the scene, like our planet. So our small box with the crosshair here essentially dictates the point that we want to track. So that is why when I move it around, it creates this zoomed in view to look at areas that we want to grab into. You can also look at the inside of the crosshair by making sure that you are looking at the node here and then check out on this box on the tracker node, because when I move it around, it would basically displays what the little box is looking at. So now I want to add a planet in the sky. That means we need to pick an object that has the same movement as the sky, like a cloud. But we don't have any cloud on our sky here. So in this case, our faraway mountain is good enough for the track. So let's track the mountain. And to do that, we want to look for an area on our mountain here that is perfect for our tracker to grab, like this pointy edge on this mountain, because it's very contrasty and it has this really unique feature that our tracker can grab and memorize and follow. So then we have selected that, and you can see here on this box, we have selected that pointy part of the mountain. And to track, you want to select one of these buttons. And because we are on a frame 0 here, the first frame, we can just click track forward. And here you can see our tracker is grabbing and following that area of that mountain. And from that, we have generated a transform data. However, the transform data that we generated currently is only the translation data, which is the X and Y, the up and down and left and right. Before we go further, don't forget to hit like and subscribe for more tutorials like this one. And now, let's go back to the video. If we want to produce other transform data, like scale and rotation, we're going to need the help of other trackers. So let's create another one. So what's going to happen is, we're going to track these two points independently. And Fusion is going to calculate the distance and position difference between these two points to generate scale and rotation data. Think of it like steering wheel, and these two points are your right and left hand on the steering wheel. So now let's track the second tracker. And because we already have our tracker one, tracking a point that is leaning towards the left, let's track a point that is leaning towards the right, like this bump on this mountain here that I think is good enough to track. Okay, so now before we track our second tracker, we want to make sure to disable the tracker one so we don't track it again. And then let's track forward. And there we go. So now let's turn on our tracker one again. Okay, so now we have generated tracking data from our two tracker. Let's convert this into a transform data that we can use on our planet. So we want to go to operations, and then on the operation, we want to change this to match move. So now what happens is our tracker node has essentially become like a merge node, except with our tracking data embedded on it, which we can see right here. We are applying the position data and rotation and scaling. So if you just want to have the position data, you can just disable these two and you will have the position data only. Or if you just want the scaling data or just the rotation data, you can do that as well. And here on our merge, we have foreground over background. So that means we're gonna have our tracking data applied to anything that is inputted to our merge foreground. So for example, if we put our planet here, you can see that the tracking data is applied to our planet and now it's moving along with the plate. But you can change this to other stuff as well. For example, if you want just foreground only, so now you're just applying the tracking data to the planet without the background. So you can merge this to another plate if you want to, or you can just choose background only. And if you choose background only, you would essentially apply the tracking to our plate, except the tracking data is being applied in reverse, which results in our shot being stabilized based on our tracker. So this method is usually used for creating that stabilized head effects that you see in music videos. And then you can also choose background and foreground, which essentially just switch the foreground and the background. So now the background is on top of our planet. For this, let's stick with foreground over background. Okay, so now we have our planet sticking into the scene. Let's blend our planet. Let's go to the tracker node and change the apply mode to overlay. That way, all the dark area of our planet is blended with the background, creating this faraway horizon look. And then let's add some curve. And I want to disable the alpha. And let's darken the highlights of our planet. And then because our planet here is really far away, let's add a little bit of defocus. And there we go. We have our planet being motion tracked into the scene. Now that you know how to motion track, you can start adding cool looking VFX elements like this planet, which you can purchase anytime at actionvfx.com. At ActionVFX, we provide vast library of high-quality VFX stock footage for your projects. From fire and smoke, energy effects and explosions, and many, many others. You can purchase them directly or sign up to our subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library. It's saving you at least 80% off, including our subscribers-only free collections, and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. I encourage you to drop a like and let us know in the comment section below what kind of tutorials that you'd like to see next. But most of all, be sure to subscribe. We are aiming for 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year. And also, there are other resources on this channel, such as other VFX tutorials, podcasts, VFX breakdowns, and many others. So be sure to check them out as well. Let us be your number one resource for visual effects. So, see you next time. Bye-bye.